In a study done by the job board Glassdoor in 2017, they found on average 250 resumes are being submitted for every job opening. Now, in other studies, what has been found is that over 98% of Fortune 500 companies are using some form of applicant tracking system to sort, rank, and filter these resumes. But they're not just an applicant tracking system, that is not just for large companies. In other studies, it's been found that 35% of small to medium-sized firms are also using applicant tracking systems. So what does this mean for you? Well, number one, it's something that I think all coaches and career counselors will tell you, that your best chances of landing that interview are going to be through networking and referrals, not by just mindlessly sending out your resume. However, if you are sending out your resume, I would really take the time to make sure that it's applicant tracking system friendly. And there's a great resource out there that you can use. It's called Jobscan, and I want to talk about that in today's video. I think the best way to describe Jobscan is to actually show it to you. So brought up my browser, and I'm going to go to the website www.jobscan.co, and it's not co, it's .co, and I'm going to leave a link to Jobscan in the notes section below. So I'm going to click on this, and I'm on the main screen of Jobscan. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this resource, but I want you to know it's available to you. I've spoken with so many clients who have never heard of Jobscan, and it's an incredible resource for seeing how well your resume may be handled by an applicant tracking system. So they've actually designed Jobscan based upon some of the most popular, most used applicant tracking systems out there on the market. There's a couple of links up here. Definitely check out what is Jobscan. There's a couple of videos in there that really explain it more in detail. Some resources out there. Create an account on this. And down at the bottom down here, something I want to show you as well. And I think there's other ways to get to it, but there's the blog here. And there are some really good articles when it comes to the blog. And you can sit here, how to use Twitter in your job search. How three real Jobscan users landed their dream job, what happens to resume tables and columns in an ATS. You can actually see for yourself. There's some charts out there. Love these articles. You can click here for browse all the articles, and there's a subscribe button right there. So something you may definitely want to check out. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the main page of Jobscan. You can actually use this program 5 times a month, completely free. You can pay to use it for more than that, and there's a lot more features that come up with this. And I'll leave a link again in my notes section below. So let me just show you essentially what happens is that you're going to copy and paste your resume, and then you're going to copy and paste the job description over here on the other side, and then you're going to click on scan. But there's a way here to do a trial of the sample resume, and let me just show you how this looks. So you see that there is a resume that was uploaded there, and then copy and pasted a job description. They hit the scan button. This is all being automatic, and you see this when you go into the site as well. But it comes up as a rate of 68%. Jobscan recommends having a match rate of about 80% to really make your resume pop out and catch the attention. So what it does is it breaks things down. So you see the ATS findings, recruiter findings, skill match, format check, cover letter checks if you submitted a cover letter. The ATS findings, I think, is probably one of the most crucial, because it goes through and it talks about the skills and keywords and what you may be missing. So again, I'm not going to go item by item on this. I want you to play with this yourself. However, as I go down, so these are the, you know, here in the right hand corner or right hand side, these are from a 5,000 foot view, and then as we go down, it kind of gets it closer to the ground, what we're looking at. I want to come down here to the hard skills. I think this is the most important area on the resume that I want you to be aware of. This is where talking about, okay, hard skills like customer experience, Android, iPhone, these are keywords that may be being searched by the recruiters out there. And what it's showing is that, for example, customer experience, your resume had zero mentions on it, but the job description actually had three. iPhone, which was a hard skill, resume had zero mentions on it, and the job description had two mentions. Also comes down, I think, a little bit less important, but something you might want to be aware of is the soft skills out there, that they had some words that maybe would be a little bit better to match. So this is a really great resource to test to see how your resume will do with an applicant tracking system. Again, the cost of this is, so there are some prices. Let me just show you real quick here. If we go down to the bottom, I believe they were down here again, or under plans, and you see that we got a free plan here, which is you can do this five times a month. There's a 1 month, well, it's actually the most popular. It looks like every 3 months for $90, but you get the first month free, or you can do a monthly charge on that. And I have a link in my notes section below. I will mention that I am an affiliate of this program, but only because I absolutely love JobScan. And whether you do the free or the monthly, I mean, that's your choice there, but it is a great resource when you're in career transition, or you're just looking for another job and you're applying for some of these large firms out there that are likely using applicant tracking systems. So I hope you check out the resource JobScan. Again, I have the link to the website in the notes section below. If you haven't already subscribed to this channel, I really encourage you to do so, especially if you're in career transition or you're just simply looking for a new job, because I do upload new career tips and strategies just like this one every Tuesday. Thanks for stopping by, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.